This morning, we are combining food and the best places to get it with the help of our resident Globetrotter. Travel journalist Oneika Raymond is just back from a trip to Uzbekistan. We're going to talk about that. She's here in studio to chat foodie destinations. Welcome back. We're glad we could grab you for a minute before you're off on your next adventure.
For 1 minute only.
For 1 minute. All right. Yes. So let's talk. Let's start here in Canada. It's a big country. And you say to go all the way to the west coast of Richmond, B.C. to get great food.
Yes, you must definitely do that. I mean, Richmond is located on the Pacific coast, has more than 800 restaurants for you to wet your whistle.
Okay.
And in particular, they have a lot of great Cantonese cuisine. So my recommendation is to delve into that and as well get some of the seafood. There's a restaurant called Chef Tony's Seafood Restaurant where you can get fish that's been freshly caught.
Oh, everyone loves that. Everyone wants to know that when they go to a fresh fish restaurant, it's the freshest fish you can get.
Exactly. They're still doing their thing. They're still flipping.
Now, in terms of international cuisine, you're picking this city right here. You're picking Toronto.
Oh, my goodness. So Toronto is my hometown, and I love it so much. And one of the reasons I love it is because I like to eat, and there is a lot of food here. You will not have a destination that has more international restaurants packed into city squares. And so you can get Korean food. There's a Chinatown. There's Little Italy. Also, if you have dietary restrictions, if you're vegan, there is this huge festival that's called Vegandale that's been started here. And also, there's lots of great Jamaican food. I'm of Jamaican background. And Diner's Corner is the place to go. And Randy's Patties are the best.
I can't say that I've ever been to Vegandale. My invitation must have got lost.
I think you're missing
in
out.
In the mail. I am not missing out. I see what it is, Oneika, is I don't place restrictions on my diet.
Okay.
I experience it all. And every now and then I do go vegan. It's called a salad. And then I move on to my steak.
Okay, so no comment. Okay. No comment on
now,
that.
Now, if you're headed to the United States, South Carolina is your pick for as an upcoming foodie destination.
Yes. So Greenville has burst out onto the food scene. Most notably, it has more than 120 restaurants within a 10-block radius.
Really?
And you can find everything to, you know, sate your palate. However, when you go to South Carolina, you got to indulge in that barbecue.
Mm-hmm.
And Bucky's Barbecue is the place to go. The South Carolina Barbecue Association actually has a list of places that you should drive 100 miles for.
Really?
And Bucky's Barbecue was on this list. So make sure to get some Southern hospitality, Southern cooking, and some of that Southern BBQ.
I'm telling you, one of the great things to do also is follow these places on Twitter. And you'll learn a lot about what they do, their methods and everything. And if it's something that tickles you, tickles your tummy bone, if that's
sure.
a thing, get on a plane
we
and go down there.
Tickle
your tummy bone. I like that. All right. Speaking of which, some people adore their deep dish pizza, and there's no better place, you say, than Chicago.
You have to go to Chi-Town for your pizza. Gino's and Burt's are kind of the best known places for that. But the great thing about Chicago is that they put a spin on a lot of American classics. So they have the Chicago version of pizza, of hot dogs. Chicago steak is also something that
What's
you have to indulge in.
What's a Chicago steak?
You know what? I'm not entirely sure because I don't eat steak. I think it's fried a certain way, like it's rare in the middle, but like...
All right, so like blue in the middle?
Maybe not quite so blue. I actually don't eat beef, funnily enough.
Well, listen, if anybody at home knows what a Chicago steak is, let me know because
I
like to try it all. Okay, so we were talking about foodie destinations in North America, but you just got back from a trip to Uzbekistan. Was it everything you hoped it would be?
So Uzbekistan is stunning architecturally, and it's located in Central Asia. It's a former Soviet republic, and it's landlocked, and it's just it's located in this expansive region. The food is, there are a lot of grilled meats.
Okay.
Lots and lots and lots of grilled meats.
Something I'm a big fan of. Look at that.
Horse is one of the things that they eat there. I had a little bit of it. I wasn't that huge of a fan. But I think it's really important when you travel to these places to try local cuisine. They also kind of have this milk that's like a fermented mare's milk. So mare being horse mare.
Oh, you lost me there.
So the man who does not have any dietary restrictions is saying
I'm not saying
no
I wouldn't
to...
try it. I'm just saying I know I wouldn't like it. Oneika, thank you for being here. Congratulations. Welcome home.
Thank you so much for having me.